The 2020 Olympic Games will be held in Tokyo from the 24th of July to 9th of August. Preparations are in the final stretch and organizers are now working on ways to raise excitement and enthusiasm for the Games. As part of this promotional campaign, the official mascots of Olympic and Paralympic Games embarked on a tour of Europe on Wednesday. So over the next few days, the mascots, Mirai Towa and Sumaiti, will be visiting six cities in Europe that have hosted the Olympic and Paralympic Games in the past. The pair will promote the Make the Beat campaign, a rhythm which fans can dance to or clap along with when watching the action at Olympic and Paralympic Games. This, the organizers hope, will improve the atmosphere and also heighten excitement around the sport taking place in a few months from now. So on this edition of In Depth, we tell you all about the Tokyo 2020 mascots, how they've been selected and what they signify. We'll also understand the importance of mascots in sporting events and also talk about some of the game's mascots that have been extremely popular in the past. Mascots are used to welcome visitors to sporting events. They enhance the excitement of children, adults, and fans alike. They make the events memorable long after they have even concluded. Usually, the mascot design represents a prominent feature or an animal of the host country, or even at times its culture and heritage. In this report, let's introduce you to the official mascots for the 2020 Olympic and Paralympic Games, which will be held in Tokyo in July and August this year.
London and Lausanne to promote the Make the Beat campaign of the Tokyo 2020 organizers. Their European tour is aimed at generating excitement and enthusiasm for the Tokyo Games, which begin on the 24th of July. Before leaving for Europe, the duo were treated to a departure ceremony at the Haneda Airport. Japanese volleyball player Megumi Kurihara joined the pair in performing the signature Make the Beat clapping routine. The send-off ceremony for Mirai Towa and Sumaiti also featured a video message from American pop group The Backstreet Boys.
The upcoming year will be Tokyo 2020 Olympic and Paralympics. I am sure Tokyo is very excited.
The mascots Mirai Towa and Sumaiti are cartoon-style characters meant to be the embodiments of Japanese culture and the spirit of the Olympic and Paralympic Games. In their official Tokyo 2020 biographies, they are described as having superpowers and an ability to teleport between the digital world and reality. The two are also described as great friends who are extremely athletic and can participate in every event, from basketball and tennis to archery, kayaking and horseback riding.
The Tokyo's thing is called Mirai Towa, which is basically, the word comes from a Japanese word, which means future. That is basically, it is called teleportation. It was designed by Ryan Taniguchi. He designed it. So basically, it conveys the technological aspects of Japanese. Somaiti means eternity. That's how it is designed. So that is only to tell how technology has overtaken everything, and Japanese believe in the technology, so they try to link it to that, and that is the idea.
Mirai Towa, the Olympic mascot, has a personality inspired by the Japanese proverb, learn from the past and develop new ideas. It is cheerful, remarkably athletic, and also has a very strong sense of integrity. It also has a special power to instantly teleport anywhere it wants. It has been styled with the A, indigo blue Ichimatsu pattern from the Tokyo 2020 Games emblem, and is a tribute to both the respected tradition and modern innovation of Japanese culture. The name Mirai Towa is based on the Japanese words Mirai, which means future, and Towa, which means eternity. It represents the wish that through the Tokyo 2020 Olympic Games, a future of everlasting hope will carry on in the hearts of everyone around the world. While the name Sumaiti comes from Somiyoshino, a popular type of cherry blossom, and the phrase Somaiti. Somaiti also has several superpowers. It can fly using its pink Ichimatsu pattern cape. The cherry blossom tactile sensors or antennae on the sides of its face give it telepathic abilities, including telepathic communication, the ability to talk to stones and the wind, and also the ability to move objects simply by looking at them. Its dignity and physical and mental strength represent the superhuman power of Paralympic athletes who overcome several obstacles and redefine the boundaries of possibility. For the first time in Olympic history, the mascots for the Tokyo Games were chosen exclusively by elementary school children. Children in 16,769 Japanese elementary schools participated in the voting. Prior to the voting, mascot candidates were submitted for consideration. Any Japanese national or foreign resident over the age of 18 could contribute. Each submission contained not only an illustration but also a profile of the mascot's personality and its relation to Japan. The Tokyo 2020 Organizing Committee received more than 2,000 entries. The children voted on sets of finalists labeled Pair A, Pair B and Pair C. The winning pair was designed by Japanese artist Ryo Taniguchi. After the selected mascots were unveiled, the mascot selection panel voted on a short list of proposed mascot names. Now, as the official mascots embark on a European tour, preparations are underway in Tokyo, with the Olympic flame due to arrive in Japan on the 20th of March. Bureau Report, Rajya Sabha TV.
Well, usually most sport teams and events are known not by their stats, but by their team mascot. Mascots are crucial to the success of an event or, in fact, a team as well, as they are a crucial piece of their branding. So in our next report, we talk about the significance of mascots in general and their need in sports.
Mascots. Nowadays, we see them everywhere. At sports events, schools, even at trade shows, on Twitter and on commercials. They are becoming an increasingly popular phenomena across many different media. Mascot is a character, a personified image that becomes a symbolic representation of a brand, company or even a public figure. The term origins from the French word mascotte, that means lucky charm.
Mascot is basically, it symbolizes the games. Usually it is decided on, you know, some kind of an animal, popular animal in that country. Just like in India, we call it peacock, is a national thing. So as it is, then you have to look at these things. Basically, what happens when you, for any games, when you look at a mascot, it's... symbolizes that country's popular thing, whatever. It could be a character, fictional. Most of them are fictional. They are not actually in the sense it has something deeper into it and all. It is just basically it's an ad marketing.
So what do mascots do for brand or event recall? For any event or brand, mascots enhance communication, create flexibility of personification, increase memorability and recognition, consistent visual marking, become brand voice, tone and character, create emotional appeal, have viability potential, and lend style and beautify. One of the areas where mascots have gained popularity is sports. Particularly mascots for teams whose names are based on real animals or creatures that could potentially get human-like characteristics. Mascots not only unite and support, but they also provide a big opportunity for business, including merchandising. Mascots can help promote sports team. By a well-thought-out personality, team mascots keep crowds engaged and entertained and in turn provide a boost to players, Having a mascot gives teams the opportunity to sell merchandise related to the mascot, as well as send the mascot on a community events in a bid to drive sales and marketing for the team. Mascots help engage with the crowd through their antics and playful persona. Mascots always say a lot about the team and what it may stand for.
Mascot is the organizing committee asks for entries. Lot of artists and all enter, and then the marks marks are given. Some people are selected for it, and like this Tokyo Olympics, you know, there are three people shortlisted, and that top one got some 1,000 votes in the committee. The second one was somewhere around 600. The third one is 300. So that is one way of selecting. And ironically, when the Sochi Winter Olympics were held, first time a mascot was selected on popular vote.
Mascots are unique. They have personality and they draw attention wherever they go and become a spectacle that people love. They become larger than life characters that can engage in a way that no one else can. With inputs from Vipul Agarwal, Bureau Report, Rajya Sabha TV.
Slipping into a short break here on the program. We'll be right back. Do stay with us. Welcome back. You're watching In Depth. Ever since the first unofficial Olympic Games mascot was created for the Grenoble Winter Olympics back in 1968, Olympic mascots have become a popular element of the summer as well as winter games. They allow host countries to put their own symbolic touch on the games and also allow people to interact with this immense event on a personal level. So let's now take a look at the mascots of the Olympic Games from 1968 until today.
Olympic mascots are mostly vaguely humanoid, brightly colored fictional characters, often becoming a vehicle for communicating the Olympic spirit to the general public, especially children and youth. Despite the importance of the message they convey, they are designed in a simple manner with bright, happy colors that are appropriate for the festive atmosphere of the Olympic Games. Over the decades, they have come in many shapes and sizes and showcase the distinctive geographical features, history, and culture of the host city. The idea of an Olympic mascot was officially approved in 1972 at the 73rd session of the International Olympic Committee in Munich.
1968 Grenoble Winter Olympics. It was not even official at that time. It was unofficial. Then it was adopted by the Games Committee. So, but actual mascot has started only in 72 Munich Olympics. After that, it has been a regular feature. That's not a thing.
The first official Olympic mascot was Waldy, a Dachshund, who appeared in the 1972 Summer Olympics in Munich. The dog represented the attributes required for athletes: resistance, tenacity, and agility. But the first ever Olympic mascot, albeit unofficial, came 4 years earlier at the 1968 Winter Olympics in Grenoble, France, called Schuss, a little man on skis. Since then, mascots have become a major element of the Olympic brand. The first official mascot of a Winter Olympics was Schneemann, a snowman, in the year 1976. He wore a red Tyrolean hat, typically worn in Austria. A national competition was held in Canada to find a name for the mascot for the Montreal Olympics. Amic, meaning beaver, was chosen because it is the national symbol of Canada. In the 1980 Winter Olympics in Lake Placid, the name Ronnie was chosen because it means raccoon in Iroquoian, the language of the native people of Lake Placid, New York. The Moscow Olympic mascot was a bear named Misha. The mascot was developed by Viktor Chizikov, a renowned illustrator of children's books, for the 1980 Summer Olympics. The symbol of the United States, a bald eagle, was the mascot of the 1984 Olympics in Los Angeles.
The mascot for the LA Olympics was designed by Walt Disney and wore the outfit of the legendary American Uncle Sam. For the first time, the 1988 Winter Olympics had two mascots, twin polar bears Heidi and Howdy, who wore cowboy outfits. The 1988 Seoul Olympics mascot was a friendly little tiger called Hodori, which portrays the friendly and hospitable traditions of the Koreans. The cheerful Hodori wore the Olympic rings around his neck. The mascot for the 1992 Summer Olympics in Barcelona was a dog called Kobe, which had its own specially produced TV series. The mascots for the 1994 Winter Olympics in Norway was Hakon and Kristin. This was the first time the mascots were real people. The mascot of the 1996 Olympic Games in Atlanta was an abstract fantasy figure. It was given the name Izzy, derived from what is it, because no one seemed to know exactly what it was. The official mascots chosen for the 2000 Olympics in Sydney were Sid, Ollie and Millie, three typical animals of Australia representing respectively water, land and air. Athena and Phaivos, designed by Spyros Gogos, were the Olympic mascots of the 2004 Summer Olympics held in Athens. Their creation was inspired by an ancient Greek doll. The Fuwa were the mascots of the 2008 Summer Olympics in Beijing. These five mascots formed the Chinese phrase Beijing Huan Ying Ni, meaning Beijing welcomes you. Wenlock and Mandeville, the official mascots of the 2012 Summer Olympics and Paralympics in London, were meant to resemble the Olympic Stadium itself. They each have one large eye, and the yellow lights on their heads symbolize London's taxi cabs. Rio's 2016 Summer Olympics mascot was a yellow cat-like creature named Winnicus, and the mascot for the Paralympic Games was Storm, a blue and green figure whose head is covered with leaves. Su Horang, a white tiger, was the official mascot of the 2018 Winter Olympics, and Bandabi, a black bear, was the official mascot of the 2018 Winter Paralympics. And the official mascot of the 2020 Tokyo Summer Olympic Games is a smiling, futuristic creature named Mirai Towa. The mascot, which resembles both a feline superhero and a robot, gets its name from the Japanese words Mirai, meaning future, and Towa, meaning eternity. With inputs from Vipul Agarwal, Bureau Report, Rajya Sabha TV.
Well, from July, the sporting world will descend on Tokyo for the 2020 Summer Olympics as well as the Paralympic Games. An estimated 6 lakh overseas visitors are expected to flock to the Japanese capital as well as the surrounding regions. And the Games, as they are every 4 years, will be an endurance test of planning and logistics for the organizers as well as attendees. So here's everything that you need to know about the most awaited sporting extravaganza of the new decade.
The 2020 Summer Olympic Games will be held in Japan's capital, Tokyo, from July 24th to August 9th. This is Tokyo's second time hosting a Summer Olympics, 56 years after their first turn. These games will see the introduction of some new exciting sports to the Olympic lineup. Skateboarding, karate, surfing and sport climbing will all make their Olympic debut. There will be plenty of classics to watch as well, from the ever-popular swimming and gymnastic events to track and field and team sports. Beginning July 24th, audiences around the world will be able to tune in to 2 weeks of non-stop sports. Most of the big swimming events will take place over the first week, while the track and field competitions ramp up in the second half. The 2020 Summer Olympics will award medals across 339 events representing 33 different sports. 5 are new sports entirely: baseball and softball, skateboarding, surfing, sport climbing and karate, plus a few new events like the 3-on-3 basketball competition. Nothing has been dropped since 2016, which also saw the return of golf and rugby. Tokyo has renovated many of its pre-existing facilities to stage the 2020 Games. Of the 43 total venues, 25 are already standing, while 8 are new and 10 more temporary.
Hosting the Olympics is a complex proposition for any city, while it offers potential economic upsides thanks to increased construction, investment and tourism. Many cities also struggle to make use of the expansive facilities and housing that the Games require after the sporting extravaganza is over. Here are some impressive facts about Tokyo and the events the city will host. The 2020 Games will feature facial recognition on a broad scale, cameras and microphones installed en masse to cut down on potential criminal activity, robotic baggage assistance at the airports, and even fleets of driverless cars designed to serve the massive influx of directionally challenged tourists. Japan also has something extraordinary in store to mark the opening ceremonies, a human-made meteor shower. For marathon and race walk events, Tokyo planners have selected routes marked by iconic landmarks. The tranquil beauty of the Imperial Palace Gardens will preside over the participants in the race walk. Meanwhile, cycling routes will embrace the best of both traditional and modern Tokyo. In an innovative move, Japan has instituted a program that encourages citizens to recycle their old smartphones, which have then been mined for precious metals that are present in them in small quantities. The produce of the program is being used to craft the Olympic medals awarded at each event. But while it's an apparent exercise in sustainability, it also serves another valuable purpose. By donating their devices, Japanese citizens contribute to the Games in a personal way, making the 2020 Olympics a legitimate community effort. Tokyo was ranked as the safest city in the world by a 2017 analysis based on 49 indicators of health, personal and cybersecurity, and even access to amenities and hospitals. With the enhanced technology and focus on increased tourist amenities for the Games, all visitors can be sure to celebrate safely when they arrive in Tokyo. The flame lighting ceremony will take place in ancient Olympia, home of the ancient Games in Greece, on 12th March 2020. At the Temple of Hera, a modern high priestess will ignite the Olympic flame in the traditional way by using the rays of the sun and a parabolic mirror. Tokyo 2020 has been working towards the implementation of the ISO 21-21 standard with the goal of ensuring more consistent sustainability efforts at all stages of the Games, from the preparation phase up until after the Games have ended. The ISO 21-21 certification will provide Tokyo 2020 with a recognized framework to be respected as it continues to ensure the sustainability of the Tokyo Olympic Games. The Tokyo 2020 Organizing Committee's official Games motto is United by Emotion. The motto emphasizes the power of sports to bring together people from diverse backgrounds and allow them to connect and celebrate in a way that reaches beyond their differences.
We are each different and awesome.